Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will see 24 keys, keyboard, switch array, switch matrix for weight machines, weight scales. It can be used with any microcontroller, any microcomputer, either it is big, whatsoever. How it works? It have 24 switches on the switch panel, which are used to define any function. For example, here it is number 7. So this button will number 7. When we will press, microcontroller will sense which switch is pressed. If you see it spin out, it have only 10 wires. We have 24 switches. How these switches are configured with 10 wires and how processor will know which pin is coming from which switch. How the processor will define which key is pressed. When we will understand its function, we can test it very easily, we can configure it very easily. Basically, this keypad, this switch array, it uses a row and column method. If you see from this point, this row number 1, row number 2, the switches are in rows 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 rows, and it have columns 1, 2, 3, 4 columns, 6 rows, 4 columns. Sometime it is called 6 by 4 switch matrix. That means 6 rows, 4 columns. Your processor wants to take any data from the operator, it uses this matrix. We can enter the data. For example, this is a microcontroller. It has 6 rows. So it will use these 6 lines one by one. It will not activate all the lines at the same time. It will activate one line and it will take a roll call from these 4 output lines. For example, if row number 1, this is row number 2, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6. Here is C1, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. When it will activate row number 1, we have just only these 4 switches active. If I will press any one switch, the high line, for example, the processor writes 5 volt here and he will check column 4, column 3, column 2, column 1, any switch I will press in that time when this line is active, that will reach at this pin. For example, I press this switch here. When I will press this switch, at that time R1 column 1, processor will receive a pulse from this switch. At that time, processor knows that it enabled pin number 10. When pin number 10 is enabled, it will receive voltage at pin number 5. Now, when the first row is activated and we press the first switch here, at that time it will make a jumper between the first row and this input. At that time, this switch will make easy path to this pin. When the processor will take the same generated voltage, for example, it is 5 volt, it will receive back 5 volt. It will become to know that when pin number 10 is high and it receives 5 volt at pin number 5, that means this switch, row 1, column 1, this switch is activated and it will do its function, what to do, and it have to make decision. For example, anyone will press this button, this generated voltage will reach to this port, so it will receive the signal that the user pressed this key, that is R1 C3, row 1 column 3. It scans this array in very fast speed. For example, it will scan in 1000 times in 1 second, 1 millisecond for this time. Then disable this line, it will enable row 2. When row 2 is enabled, it will check that any key is pressed, and it will keep swapping these lines, these rows, one by one. It will select the line and it will send 5 volts or 3.3 volt signal. Which type of processor is there? It will write high signal, and it will seek these 4 lines. We can say these are output lines to take roll call, and it will receive roll call, it will receive the inventory, which switch is pressed, it will receive back the pulse from here. Let's check this matrix. We have these micro switches. The configuration of this micro switch continuity. So this switch have 4 terminal. These 2 points are common together, and these 2 points are shorted together, common together. When we will press this button, it will make jumper between this point and this point. Now I will press the first button. This time it is open. When I will press this first button, it will give continuity. Now, if we trace back here, this first line, it is reaching here. As we discussed, these switches have common line here. This switch, this side is common together. So this side is common together. In this matrix, if we see this first switch, it is jumpered from this side to this point. From inside this switch, it is reaching here. Then here, the third row, fourth row, fifth row. If I will press this button, the signal will reach from this point at pin number 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 9, 8, 7. This is our first row input, 10, 9, 8, 7. This is our first row output, 7 is output. If I will press this button, we will receive output from first button. From the second column, it is receiving the same line here, this point, track here, from inside this switch here. So it is passing here, from this line it is reaching at this point. So if we will press, this is input for first row. Now if I press this button, the number 2 button, it will give continuity. Now first row, the same here, row and column. First row is connected to pin number 4. If you see this connector ribbon cable, the first wire, it is marked with red color. So this pin here to guide, this is pin number 1. I will connect this wire It is a resistor actually. I am connecting this resistor here and I will connect to pin number 4. This is in this connector. This is red wire. It is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. This pin is pin number 4. And if we check here, the first raw output, that is pin number 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. 4 and 7. First switch will activate. If now we will check raw 1, column 2 switch, it will give continuity at pin number 8. Here we have pin number 8. So this is column 2. This is. Now if we will press this button, it will not give continuity because it is connected to pin number 7. Because this column is connected to pin number 7. This is connected to pin number 8. Now we will connect pin number 9. 9 is connected to the fourth column. That is here. If I will press this button, between pin number 4, the first row, and pin number 7, 8, 9, and 10. Pin number 10, that is column 3. Here we have row, these four lines, these are for columns. Now we are in column 3. Pin number 10 is dedicated to column number 3. Yes. Now we will shift to row number 2. Row number 2 is connected to pin number 2. That is here. This is row number 2. Row number 2, column number 3. Row number 2, column number 3. This is. Now any other switch will not respond to this pin because it is dedicated, because this is dedicated to row number 2, column number 3. Row number 2, column number 3, so this switch is now active. If I want to check this switch, I will connect to pin number 7. Here we have pin number 7. This is pin number 7. When processor will enable row number 2, anyone will press this button, it will understand that row number 2, column number 1 button is pressed. For example, I want to test this switch. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, row number 5. It is pin number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pin number 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, column 1, row 5, column 1, this switch is active now. You will check column number 2, it is connected to pin number 8, so we will connect pin number 8, that is column 2. This switch, it is giving some resistance, but it is giving continuity. The main problem in these micro switches, these have very bad behavior with dust, rust. So some carbon, some dust, rust makes resistance and it drops the digital signal. Now if we want to test column number 3, it is pin number 10. This is column number 3. Column number 4, that is pin number 9. It is here. Now if you want to test row number 6. Row number 6 is connected to pin number 6. It is pin number 6. Pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. So we are now at pin number 6. That is row number 6. Row number 6. If you want to check column number 1. So here we have this switch. Now if you want to test pin number 8. That is column column number 2. This is column number 2. If we want to test switch at row number 6, column number 3, at that time we will connect to pin number 10. Row number 6, column number 3, it will give continuity. In this way, the processor, the microcontroller enables one row at a time and it waits for any input. If row number 1 is enabled, anyone will press any switch from this row, it will give signal to these 4 pins, any one pin. For example, this switch is pressed, it is connected to this port, this switch to second port. So processor microcontroller will define that it have enabled first row and it received at column 1. So row number 1, column number 1, it will define its function, it will use the function defined with this switch. What to do? Either it have to clear the entry, either it have to store in memory, either it have to make 0, any function. For example, number 7 digit is defined with this button, so at that time it will display number 7 on the screen. It will multiply the unit rate and it will give a total price. Let's see it practically. When it is connected to the machine, row number 1, that is here, and this pin is now connected to microcontroller, microcontroller this pin. The programmer, the software designer will write a signal that the physical position for the row number 1 is here at this pin. So this pin will become high and it will seek this pin. If I want to connect this pin, it will check that this pin is here. Now if the processor will take the connection between this pin and pin number 8, at that time it will become to know that this button is pressed, number 7 digit is pressed. If I will press number 7 digit here, it will display 7, 8, 9, 0, 1, clear, 2, 3. Now, if someone will put some weight, it will automatically multiply with weight, price, and the total amount. For example, if it is displaying this weight, someone want to make tear, it will make 0, clear, tear. So in this way we can understand, we can test the switch matrix, the keypad with multimeter, and we can configure it. I will give the link of this switching matrix circuit diagram in the video description. You can find the link in the video description and you can download it. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.